गुड मॉर्निंग गाइस, सो वेलकम बैक टू आवर चैनल। सो टुडे वी आर हियर विद वन मोर इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन, दैट इज़ विद AT&T, एंड दिस वॉज शेयर्ड बाई वन ऑफ आवर सब्सक्राइबर फ्रेंड। सो इफ यू आर लुकिंग आउट फॉर द इंटरव्यू क्वेश्चन दैट आर बींग आस्क्ड एट AT&T, सो दिस इज़ द वीडियो फॉर यू, एंड दिस विल डेफिनेटली हेल्प मेनी अदर्स एज वेल, बिकॉज दिस वॉज आस्क्ड टू अ 13 ईयर्स एक्सपीरियंस कैंडिडेट। सो आई होप दैट दिस वीडियो विल बी हेल्पफुल टू ऑल ऑफ यू। So let us first check the mail that we got. So if you see, here is the mail. We got this on 30th May, 30 May 2021, and our subscriber friend says, "You guys are doing great work. These are the questions that I have faced during the interview yesterday." So that is 29th May. "I have 13 years of experience. Please keep my identity hidden." So to that we have replied, "Thanks for sharing. Can you please let us know the company name?" So the company was AT&T. So that this is about the email. Now let us dive into the questions that were asked to us. So first we talk about the topic. Let us talk about the topics which were from where the questions were asked. So from Core Java, JSP, Spring Boot, SQL, project architecture related questions, and Unix. So these were the topics that were shared, like that were asked. And please don't forget to like this video. It will definitely motivate us as well as the contributors. So let us start the question. So first question is, what is static initializer block? So static initializer block is a static block of code inside a Java class and run only one time before the constructor or main method is called. So answers, we have just trying to give online answers at least. So basically the questions were shared by our subscriber friend and answers we have added to it. It is not the answer that was shared by the subscriber friend. So these are the answers that we have added. So basically one line answers. So the next question is, where the static blocks get stored inside memory? So basically static blocks get stored on the meta space of native heap as they are associated with the class. Externalization in Java, or what is externalization in Java? So externalization is used whenever we need to customize serialization mechanism. If a class implements an externalizable interface, then object serialization will be done using a write external method. So inside that we can specify what all we want to serialize, and we can exclude whatever we don't want to serialize. So next question, what is heap memory in Java? So simple, like heap memory is a runtime data area from which the memory for all the classes, class instances and arrays is allocated. The heap is created when the Java or JVM, basically when JVM starts up, the heap memory gets created and may increase or decrease in the size while the application runs. The size of the heap can be specified using -xms VM options. Next question, what is system.gc? No, sorry, garbage collection in Java. So this was the only thing that was given. So basically garbage collection is a process of reclaiming the runtime unused memory automatically. In other words, it's a way to destroy the unused objects. The next question is on the same thing, which is system.gc. What is system.gc, or what system.gc will do? So basically java.lang.system.gc method runs the garbage collector. Calling this suggests that the Java virtual machine expend effort towards recycling unused objects in order to make the memory they currently occupy available for quick reuse. So this was about the system.gc. Next question, how to avoid deadlocks? So this we have copied from one of the site that we follow. So although it is not possible to avoid deadlock condition, but we can avoid it by using the following ways: avoid unnecessary locks, avoid nested locks, using thread.join method, use lock ordering, lock timeout. So these are the few things by using which we can eradicate a deadlock scenario, but 100% we cannot guarantee that it will eradicate that issue. Coming to the next question, ways to create threads. So there are two ways, what we said, one is by extending the thread class and by implementing runnable interface. And yes, we can argue here, we can use executable framework as well. So just we haven't written there, but we can use that well. So don't forget to use the Amazon link that is there in the description on your next purchase from Amazon. Coming to the next question, can we synchronize process, not thread? To be honest, I am also not sure on this answer. If you know the answer, you can comment it out. What is re-entrant lock? As the name says, re-entrant locks allows a threat to enter into the lock on a resource more than once. Like more than once a system can enter into the lock. Like basic question we can say. If you work on threading, you will know that. Use of generics in core Java. So basically generics usually provide compile time type safety that allows programmers to catch invalid types at compile time itself. So that is the advantage of generics. What is type erasure in generics? So type erasure is a process in which compiler replaces a generic parameter with an actual class or bridge method. In type erasure, compiler ensures that no extra classes are created and there is no runtime overhead. So to be honest, even I don't know this, I just googled the question and I got the answer. What is functional interface and how it is related to Lambda? So simply to in a simple words, Lambda simplify the use of interfaces that declare single abstract method. So basically Lambdas get operate on functional interfaces. What is obfuscation? Making jar not to decompile and how to do it. So that was the question. So this is not the answer related to it. Difference between JSP include action and include directive. So this is what we could get it from the site, one of the site we follow. So include resources at translation time, include action resource at request time, better for static pages, this is better for dynamic pages, include the original content in generated servlets, cause the include method, that are the differences. This is related to JSP. How to pass parameters from one JSP to another? As far as I remember, there are three ways: using query parameter, using hidden variables, using session object. If there are any other ways, you can please comment. What is the JSP use bin? So JSP use bin action tag is used to locate or instantiate a bin class. If bin object of a bin class is already created, it doesn't create the bin depending on the scope. But if object of the bin is not created, it instantiates the bin. So that is the use of use bin. Then comes the Spring. What are the advantages of Spring Boot? So there are many. So pointed out few here. It is very easy to develop Spring-based applications with Java or Groovy. It reduces lot of development time and increases productivity. It avoids writing lots of boilerplate code. One of the most famous advantage at removing the boilerplate code annotations and XML configurations. It is very easy to integrate Spring Boot application with Spring ecosystem like Spring JDBC, Spring ORM, Spring Data, Spring Security, Spring Cloud. Anything, it is very easy. It follows opinionated defaults configuration approach to reduce developer effort. It provides embedded HTTP servers, Tomcat and Jetty to develop and test our applications very fast and easily. How security is provided by Spring Boot? There are many ways to do that. It depends from project. It differs from project to project. What is the default server provided by Spring Boot? By default, it uses Tomcat 7. As far as I know, it is Tomcat 7. The version can be different. How to change the server port in Spring Boot? Using directly application.properties, the application.properties, you can directly specify server.port equal to whatever post you want to run, or using JWing arguments like -d server.port, we can use both the ways we can change. How to secure the REST APIs? There are different approaches available depending on your requirement. You can choose like OAuth is there, JWT is there. There are others as well. So it depends on the project on which you are working and what you have choose, why you have choose that. What is OAuth and how it functions? So OAuth is an authentication protocol that allows you to approve one application interacting with another on your behalf without giving away your password. So that is OAuth. This is one of the way. Difference between controller and REST controller. So that a controller is a common annotation that is used to mark a class as Spring MVC controller, while REST controller is a special controller used in RESTful web services and equivalent to controller plus response body. So whenever we are using at the rate rest controller on the controller class, we don't need to specify at the rate response body. Coming to the next question, what are views? Can we perform CURD operations on views? So views is nothing but a virtual table. We can create a view by joining two or more tables with or without filter criteria based on our need. Yes, we can perform CURD operations in simple view, that is on single table view, but if it is a complex view, then we cannot perform CURD operations on it. What is Cartesian product? So Cartesian products also referred to as a cross join, returns all the rows in all the tables listed in the query. What is outer join? An outer join is used to return results by combining rows from two or more tables, but unlike an inner join, the outer join will return every row from one specified table even if the join condition fails. Differences between clustered and non-clustered indexes. So clustered indexes are fast, non-clustered are slow. Clustered indexes require less memory for operation, they require more memory for operation. Clustered index is main data, it is a non-clustered is a works on copy of data. A table can have one clustered index, a table can have multiple non-clustered index. Clustered index store pointers to block non-data, non-clustered index store both value and a pointer to actual row that holds the data. So these are the differences that we could find. Project architecture microservices interview questions, like the project was a microservices project was there, so on that thing the questions were asked. So these are the four questions that were asked. Explain about your project architecture. So I have to explain in detail about the project architecture. So irrespective of your experience, you have to be good at this while explaining your project, because this is one of the deciding question. Because if you don't know about your project itself, it is very hard to believe you that you have an hands-on experience in coding. How request mapping is done in AWS from domain name to IP address? This was the second question. Explain the working of functionality of Kubernetes. How do load balancers work? So basically load balancer divides if there are multiple instances that are running, so load balancer will equally pass the traffic to both the instances or in number of instances, so that load doesn't get built on only one instance. This was about the microservices interview questions or project architecture interview questions. Next was Unix interview questions. So these are the set of questions that were asked as part of Unix. How is the Unix file structure? How to find multiple words in multiple files at the same time? How to find all words? How to find the count of occurrences in group of files? How to connect to Linux machine? Input E using same BPK file. How to connect to the two systems at a time? So these were the Unix interview questions. So here is the mail you can see. So we have you can see the entire questions we have already covered. So Core Java, JSP, Spring Boot, SQL, project architecture and Unix. So you can halt through it and you can go through the mail as well. So that's it in this video. Thank you for watching. I hope it will be helpful to you as well. If you haven't subscribed us, please do subscribe our channel. There are n number of videos that are there in the queue, as we are not getting enough time, so we are unable to post it fast. And if you are on our channel for the first time, you can visit our channel and you can see lot more interview questions like similar to this. Like there are many interview questions which are there on our channel. And thank you. If you haven't subscribed us, please do subscribe. Please do share this to other technical platforms so that it might help someone. And thank you for watching.